What's going on, guys? It's K-Dub here with another episode of Crypto Zombie. So today's episode, I want to do something a little bit different. I found this article online, and it's by Think Outside the Blocks, and it's entitled, Why Bitcoin and Crypto Have No Future. I will leave all links in the description below. However, I was actually kind of excited about this, and instead it made me want to flip it on its head and bring to you 40 reasons why you should be bullish about Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies in general. So let's start with number 40, being Overstock.com is going full crypto. And by the way, all of these articles will be available below. Moving on to number 39, we have Rockefeller-owned Venrock is investing in cryptocurrency. How about the NFL purchased a stake in a blockchain startup, Sportscaster? We also have former Trump aide and Goldman Sachs executive Gary Kahn is joining a blockchain startup. How about that time that Bill Clinton spoke at the Swell conference in support of Ripple and blockchain technology? Or what about when Steve Bannon is betting on Bitcoin and launching his own cryptocurrency? We have Robinhood offering the purchase of cryptos for absolutely commission-free. How about Plastic Bank is helping those in developing countries earn cryptocurrencies while also curing plastic ocean pollution? I know you've seen those IBM commercials. Or what about when the co-owner of the Golden State Warriors invested early in Bitcoin and thinks it's going to 1 million per coin? You guys remember when Ashton Kutcher donated $4 million in XRP to Ellen DeGeneres' charity by transferring it to her in a matter of seconds? What about the fact that Akon is launching his own cryptocurrency, Acoin, to help bring security to the currency system in Africa? Or what about the co-founder of Wikipedia is now working on its decentralized counterpart, Everpedia? How about Blockchains LLC recently buying 60,000 acres for their company that's going to incubate and innovate Ethereum-based blockchain ventures? And not only that, but they're setting up the first blockchain smart city. How about when Reddit co-founder and husband of Serena Williams, don't forget that, Alexis Ohanian, is betting on Bitcoin as a hedge to economic crisis? Or what about the fact that Binance made more in profits in Q2 of this year than the Deutsche Bank? Let's talk about Bitmain is on track for $10 billion in revenue this year after around $4 billion last year. Or how about the fact that the founder of YouTube and the founder of Twitch are advising Theta Token? What about the fact that Coinbase is valued at $8 billion? Or how about Square's Cash App that allows users to buy and sell Bitcoin? Or Goldman Sachs-backed Circle launching a crypto finance company as well as their own stablecoin? Or what about when Richard Branson thinks Bitcoin is going to bring on economic revolution and just recently, actually, first place was given to Power Ledger? Let's talk about Jack Dorsey, CEO of Twitter and Square, how he thinks that Bitcoin is the currency of the future. Or what about John McAfee betting his own manhood that Bitcoin is going to the moon? Shall we go on? I think we should. How about the fact that the Winklevoss twins took $11 million of their Facebook money and put it into Bitcoin in 2013 when it was only $120? They must have saw some value in it, correct? Or how about the fact that Yale's endowment invested $400 million in crypto asset funds? What about Alibaba and IBM have the most blockchain patents in the world? Or the fact that George Soros initially bashed cryptocurrencies only later to buy a stack of Bitcoin at the low $6,000 BTC price? How about the fact that Major League Baseball is launching their own collectibles ERC-721s on the Ethereum blockchain? Or does anybody remember when Jamie Dimon told everyone that Bitcoin was a fraud and that if he catches any of his employees owning it, he was going to fire them, while in the background, JP Morgan and Morgan Stanley bought Bitcoin ETNs on the dip? What about the fact that IBM is partnering with Stellar Lumens for cross-border payment solutions? Or the fact that Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation is utilizing Ripple's Interledger protocol to help with payment services for the financially impoverished and unbanked? We can also talk about Amazon Web Services recently partnering with Qtum. Or what about Brandon Eich, creator of JavaScript and Mozilla, started Brave Browser and a built-in ad blocker and basic attention token to reward content creators, which became a token that has been recently listed on Coinbase? Or what about when Katy Perry did this? All right, maybe that one's not so exciting. But what about when Steve Wozniak is co-founding a crypto asset investment firm? And the fact that Fidelity is offering it to its clients and has been mining it since 2015. Let's also talk about that the New York Stock Exchange is creating the cryptocurrency trading platform backed in collaboration with Microsoft and Starbucks with physically backed Bitcoin futures contracts. Or what about the fact that literally every single day there are over-the-counter trades being bought up by these institutions in just the past months, accruing almost $1 billion in over-the-counter trading? Or what about the most important thing of all, which is that cryptocurrency can actually end poverty and provide financial freedom to those in financial need? But that only brings us to number two. So what's number one? Number one is the fact that you're watching this video right now and you've stuck it out through the bear market for almost a year and you still believe in it and I'm still here. And that tells me something. There's something that you and I both see in this space, and it's a pleasure and an honor to be here with you so early on this journey because this is going to be the biggest transfer of wealth the world has ever seen. So please buckle up and get ready for the moon. That being said, I hope you enjoyed my top 40 of reasons why you should be bullish on Bitcoin. Please, if you enjoyed this, share with a friend, share with a family member, and remember why it was that you got into this in the first place. That being said, my name's K-Dub, this is Crypto Zombie. Until next time, stay crypto, and peace out.